What's up, guys? Sean Nalawani, seannal.com. And I haven't been doing a lot of supplement reviews over the past year or so because I feel like I've pretty much covered most of the popular muscle building and fat loss supplements out there in my older videos. But this is one that I haven't covered yet. So in this video, I'll be doing a quick review of CLA, which is one of the most popular fat loss supplements out there. It's one of the main ingredients that usually gets used in various fat burner blends, and it's also sold on its own. Now, I was debating whether or not to even cover this in a video, but then I noticed that one of the top five selling products on bodybuilding.com is a CLA-based fat burner, and pure CLA is still like 30th on their list of top sellers out of thousands of different products. So if even a small handful of people benefit from this video, then I think it's still worth posting. Now, I don't have a lot to say on this because it's pretty straightforward as far as I'm concerned. So I'll try to keep this concise and just give you the main points here. So CLA is a mixture of polyunsaturated fatty acids. It's found naturally in foods like beef, milk, butter, basically ruminant food sources. And it's also sold in supplement form, of course, as a stimulant-free fat burner. Now, I won't go into like the detailed biology of how CLA is claimed to improve fat loss because it's mostly just boring theoretical type stuff that most people won't really care about. I'll link the studies in the description box below for anybody who's interested. But to put it in really simple terms, CLA's main effect is that it acts on the body's PPAR receptors. It activates one variation of the receptor, PPAR alpha, which increases fat breakdown, mainly in the liver, but also in subcutaneous fat. And it inhibits another variation of the receptor, PPAR gamma, which plays a role in fat gain by creating new fat cells and also increasing appetite. And all this involves a bunch of, different fat burning enzymes, different fat storing enzymes, not really important here. But the basic idea is that CLA supplements supposedly help you burn more body fat and store less body fat. But aside from the theoretical stuff, the real question is, does CLA work? Does it actually burn fat in the real world when you take it as a supplement? And the simple answer is that CLA makes sense on paper, but if you actually look at the human research on it, and there is a decent amount available, what you see overall is either a very minor benefit or no benefit at all, which isn't surprising because the vast majority of supplements out there that are promoted as fat burners don't really do much of anything, aside from a select few exceptions. One study on 120 men or so using CLA versus a placebo for 1 year didn't show any difference between the two groups. In terms of body weight or fat mass. Another CLA study comparing CLA with sunflower oil for 12 weeks also showed no difference. Another 6-month study and an 8-week study showed the same thing. This is just a small sample. There are quite a few studies available. I'll link a bunch of them in the description box below for anybody who's interested. And even for the studies that do show positive effects, the benefit is usually really small, bordering on insignificant. And a lot of the studies also have certain flaws in them, so it's hard to know just how reliable a lot of the results are in the first place. And another important point here is that it's not just that CLA is most likely ineffective for fat loss, but when you take it in high amounts as a supplement, it might actually be bad for your health as well. When you consume CLA as part of your regular diet in smaller amounts, then it can actually have certain benefits like improving immune system function and keeping cholesterol levels in check. But when you start having too much, it can actually start to have possible negative effects. The average dietary intake of CLA is anywhere from about 1/5 of a gram up to around 1 gram, depending on your diet. Whereas the dose that's used for fat loss supplements is usually at least 2 grams up to 5 grams or more. And at that amount, some studies have shown certain side effects like increased inflammation and decreased insulin sensitivity. And I'll link those references below for you as well. But bottom line, even if CLA does burn a very small amount of fat, which it's still not even proven to do, it's probably still not a good idea to take it as a supplement in high amounts anyway because of the possible side effects. Not to mention that if you did take CLA for a year or so at around 3 grams a day, that's probably gonna cost you somewhere around $125 or so. Not a huge amount, but it all counts. And that's extra money that you could just as easily put toward other things like your gym membership or food or whatever else. Now, I know that some people will claim that they used CLA and that it worked for them, but the reality is that even if CLA does have a fat burning effect, it's still going to be small enough to where it wouldn't be something that you took and then clearly noticed that you were leaning down faster from it. I mean, in the best case scenario, you might be looking at like an extra pound or two of fat over the course of several months. Even the research supporting CLA shows very minor effects somewhere around that level. So for anybody claiming that they saw significant benefits from CLA, it would be virtually impossible to decipher the difference between losing 1 pound of fat per week versus losing 1.05 or even 1.1 pounds of fat per week. So that's really just a placebo effect. You lost fat because of your training and your diet, and not because you were supplementing with CLA. So all in all, this is just something I wouldn't recommend bothering with. There are certain supplements that can be beneficial as part of an overall muscle building and fat loss program, like I've covered in previous videos, things like protein powder, fish oil, certain vitamins and minerals, certain pre-workout compounds if you want that extra kick. But most of what's out there is basically just marketing hype, especially when it comes to the fat burner category. So my suggestion is to save your money and put most of your focus where it matters, which is on proper training and proper nutrition, since that's going to be responsible for the vast majority of your results. A few basic supplements can help out, but CLA is almost certainly not one of them. So I hope you guys found this helpful. If you appreciate this science-based, no BS approach to fitness and you want to get a complete step-by-step roadmap for gaining muscle and losing fat as efficiently as possible, the workouts, the meal plans, supplement guides, along with one-on-one coaching, then you can grab my complete body transformation blueprint by clicking here or by heading over to btblueprint.com using the link in the description box. If you enjoyed the video, as always, make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. You can also check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest updates. And you can follow me on Facebook and Instagram as well if you aren't already. The links for that are also below. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.